up and up and up. It seems like only yesterday petrol was a reasonable 90 pence a litre. And now look, over a pound and rising. I've got to get to work. Parents have to pick their kids up from school. How much is this going to cost us?
Well, I've just filled up my car for the week. It's got a 70 litre tank and it's cost me £73. This time last year it cost £61. That's a whole 12 quid increase. So what's happening to the oil price? If we look at the price of crude oil trading down the road in London, at the beginning of last year it was $50 per barrel. By the summer it had gone up to 75 bucks. And at the beginning of this year, it reached $100 for the first time ever, turning what fuels our lives into black gold.
So why has the oil price risen so dramatically, and why is it so high? I haven't got a clue, but Julian Jessop, the chief international economist at Capital Economics, thinks that he might.
Well, oil prices have been trending high for a number of reasons over the last few years. Initially, the main reason was the strength of the world economy, and particular buoyant demand from countries like China and India. More recently, the focus has shifted more towards problems on the supply side. So even though the world economy is slowing, there's still shortages and disruptions in many of the world's major economies that produce oil. Given the signs of weakness we've seen in the world economy over the last 6 months or so, it is surprising that oil prices are still this high. And that does suggest there's a substantial speculative element there that can't be justified by fundamentals.
Planes, trains, and automobiles. They're all affected by the price of the black stuff, and it doesn't stop there.
The price of our food and drink is suffering from inflationary prices, driven by the cost of transporting this glass of Merlot from Chile to putting the food on these plates behind me. Not only this, but the increase in energy prices is increasing the overheads of running a bar like this with all of its lighting and heating, adding to inflation and pushing up the cost of wining and dining after a hard day's trading on the open market. Rising energy prices is the major factor fueling inflation, according to the Bank of England, and is why inflation exceeded its 2% government target last December. Yet could this really be caused by the drinkers in this bar?
There was one man who thought he could tell me which financial speculators were piling the pounds on our petrol. That man is oil analyst Richard Savage, who thinks the finger should be pointed at hedge funds.
In our view, they've been one of the key drivers behind the rally in oil price. And basically, the price has gone from a historical average of below $20 to touching $100 at the start of this year. A major part of that momentum has been as a result of the hedge funds buying the commodity.
I then asked Richard why hedge funds have started buying up barrels of oil.
I think the key interest in commodities has been because in 2004, when equity markets were trading sideways, the commodity market was the strong area to invest in. You could have an argument that because the price that we've been paying over the past 2 or 3 years has not reflected the underlying fundamentals, we are all paying $20 a barrel, whatever the figure you want to put on it, it's more per barrel than we need to pay to support, that will be supported by the underlying fundamentals. And that excess price is going to the benefit of the hedge funds, we're all paying it. So it's effectively like a tax, a global tax on consumers.
So a bunch of financiers are effectively taxing us on top of the fuel duty and VAT we pay at the pump. But hedge funds are no ordinary bunch. They have become a force in the financial world. In the early 90s, there were a few hundred. Today, there are over 10,000, with a majority based in New York and London. In January 2007, hedge funds had $2 trillion worth of investments worldwide, which would make them the eighth largest economy in the world. Entirely unregulated, they freely invest in everything from stocks, shares, and increasingly commodities, to even betting on the weather. But you won't find hedge funds here in the city.
That's because this new breed of city slicker has set up in plush West End offices in areas like Knightsbridge, more renowned for fancy frocks and fast cars than financial thrills.
It's convenient for them. They can leave their high-paying jobs to visit high-end restaurants and shops before returning to their high-class home, all in walking distance. A partner of a hedge fund firm can expect to earn £40 million a year. And last year, there were 10 hedge fund managers who took home over $500 million each.
Their lifestyles couldn't be better. Some even date Hollywood stars like Heji Arpeb Buson, who's currently engaged to Uma Thurman. They live in Caribbean tax haven homes, but maintain instant access to the markets thanks to their Blackberries.
But these guys are difficult to track down. They don't have to list their company details, as most are registered offshore. We did try several hedge funds, including New Finance Capital and Armajaro, who deal in commodity oil markets. But hedgers are notoriously secretive, and they did not want to talk to us. Not being the kind of guy who takes no for an answer, I went back to the streets of London to see if I could find them. Do you know of any hedge fund managers here?
No, I try and avoid them.
Excuse me, are you hedge fund managers?
No.
Are you involved with hedge funds at all?
No. Thank Christ.
Are you a hedge fund manager?
Sorry.
Have you heard anything about hedge funds?
Of course I have, yes.
Do you understand really what they do?
No, I don't think anyone understands what they do at all. And I think it's best not to.
Are you involved with hedge funds at all?
No, not at all, thank you.
Are you involved at all with hedge funds? Hedge funds.
I am.
No, you are?
Hi.
How are you involved with hedge funds?
My financial advisor does that for me.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
And do you think they're a good idea?
Yes.
You do?
Yeah.
There's a lot of people who say they should be legislated. Do you think anything about that?
No, because I'd like to... No, I'm not going to talk to you. Sorry.
Desperate times led to desperate measures. Excuse me, can I take 2 seconds of your time? Have you ever heard of hedge funds?
Oh yes, I don't want anything to do with them. Thank you very much.
The hedge funds had well and truly given me the boot. But just when I was going to walk away, one was prepared to talk. He doesn't deal in commodities, but does buy shares in oil companies. Maybe he can tell me about his peers and why they're all so secretive.